So by the way, how many of you have installed this guy?
So do you know what is this guy?
What this guy is? This guy. How many of you have installed this? Okay. No? No, you don't? Only what? Do you know what is that? Yeah. It's allowed you to modify cookies,
to read cookies, where the cookies installed in the page that you're viewing, not installed in the browser, okay? It's installed in the page you're viewing, okay? It's particularly useful
when you are doing your assignment 1 and assignment 2, okay? And the name is called at this cookie. Now I would love to implement the features of this guy. How can we implement these features? Okay, very interesting. So first of all, we didn't discuss what is a Chrome extension, right?
So actually, what is a Chrome extension? A Chrome extension is a JavaScript, first of all. Okay. So later on, when we reach around the end of March, okay, we will cover how to implement a Chrome extension. Okay. So the Chrome extension by default is open source. So you can take a look at the code, okay? So if you're impatient, you can do Google to search how to read the code, or you wait until the end of the March, I will tell you how to read the code. Now basically, they are doing something called JavaScript injection, okay? So it's inject some JavaScript in the page that you're viewing. Now, what I'm going to do is,
because I didn't know, let's imagine I didn't know how to do JavaScript injection, I cannot modify the page here. So I have to demonstrate the features using some kind of strange approach, okay? So the approach is like this. First, I set up a page, okay? To verify whether I've seen any cookies that is being put into my browser, okay?
So the thing is
something like this. Let me clean this up first. Okay, so I already cleaned up before I come. Okay, so the program is very simple. I zoom in. So the program is just a JavaScript thing that will read the cookies inside your browser. Okay, now what I'm doing now, I will try to create some web queries. Okay,
so what is this form is doing? This form is, of course, this form will submit button. When I submit it, it will send a request to my server. The server, what it's doing is not memorizing anything, but generate a response with a set cookies header so that your browser will remember it. Okay? Of course, the edit this cookie button here, the extension here, is not working based on client server model. Okay? It's just doing JavaScript things on your local browser. Okay,
now I'm doing this in a client server model. Okay,
I ask server to give me a header response so that I can put some cookie there.
Okay, so we can try. Let me refresh it. Okay, so good. So nothing there. Let me try one. Hello world. Okay, cookie's name is hello where is world. Can you see this? Maybe I magnify it a bit. Okay, so how well set it. So what I'm doing is having a set cookies
header send it from a server. The server is stateless, okay? It's don't remember anything, but fire this header to your browser, and the browser now
has no cookies, right? Because it's inside the frame, okay? So I open up the frame. Okay, then you will see, wow, it's too small. Yeah, there's a hello and then a world here. Okay, so if you're not clear to you, if you won't want to install that that thing, you can use this Chrome development tools. So go to the resource tab, cookies, then you can send it, okay? So the her name is hello, the value is something. Let me magnify it. Okay, good. Okay, now continue. So what I'm going to do next, of course, I want to steal the things, okay? Now, when I steal the things, it's refreshed, but you cannot find anything.
Okay, just because I told you for every cookies you have a primary key, okay, just treat a database, okay, and there's a primary key.
In a lecture, although last time I going very fast, okay, the primary key is the name, the path, and the domain.
So, of course, both examples are running in the same domain, okay, but I'm in a different path, okay, I'm in a different path. That path, I don't know where I put it, but definitely it's different from the path that I steal the cookie. Okay, so whenever, let's say you are designing a web system or like in your assignment one, you want to inject some cookies into your system, what you should do,
you have to do the following like me. So again, it's hello in world. Now this time I put a path slash, okay?
So to make sure that this cookies can be viewed since the root of this domain, of course, you can narrow down, let's say a slash ty wall, okay, under this path, okay?
Now, under this path, you will set a new cookies with this query, okay, so I just echo it. So let's take a look here. So now you can see two entries. So two entries basically is representing two entries because they have two different primary keys, the name, domain, and the path, because the path changed. So you set two. Now, how about the place that I steal the cookie, Now this time I found something because we are in the, where's the pen? No pen. Hello. Where? Oh, okay, here. This place is strange, okay?
So we are under the big server. So let's imagine that my here is stealing cookies guy is here, one path, and another path is the setting program. So the first is set here, so it's under different path. Now I said that you set to this path, so I am under this path. I'm stealing guy, okay? And under this path, so I can see this cookie. And all the control is done by the browser only, your browser. Okay, so don't worry much, it's not anything from the control from the server, it's all inside your browser, and you can choose to see, it's because it's inside a frame, let me open it. So you can, of course, see it. Why? What? No? Then how can I steal it? This Eddy cookie stuck. Resource cookies. Yeah, I can see it. Okay, so this guy sucks. And who wrote? Oh no, what happened? I cannot explain. Okay, the first click nothing, second click have thing. Okay, yeah, it's just like the time you do your demonstration. Okay, yes, while you're demoed, you don't show the normal results. After that, you show it. Okay, yeah, no. So now this is the mechanism, okay, that I play. Of course, during the time that we talk about Chrome extension, we will also go back here to teach you how to do the JavaScript injection, to inject thing inside every pages so that you can steal the cookies, you can set the cookie, clear up the things you have. Of course, during the assignment one implementation, you can make use of this it's Chrome extension. It's called Edit This Cookie. Okay. So we already know how to play with this. So this is the path. Okay. So to make this forget your cookies. Okay. It's very simple. How to do it? Let's say it's send a request to the server with a particular CGI program and call it and make me forget. Okay. Of course, there are other parameters that I didn't show here. So when the server again is stateless, okay, you don't need to remember anything, you just echo back the parameter you send in. Let's say the parameter you send in is the cookie name is called message, the value now is the whatever. You don't need to set any value because I will set an expiry date which is early enough. So that when it's received, it will find that, oh, it's already expired.
So this is also implemented in my system. So in my system is this page. So I can choose to say delete all display cookies. Okay, then I fire our expiry time, okay, which is just now.
Just now. Of course, you can set it to some malicious times like 1970 January 1st. Okay, you know, don't set it in your iPhone. Yeah. I have an iPhone, but I don't do it. Okay,
or maybe you borrow your iPhone to me. I will try. Really, I can make it in a break or not.
Okay, so this right now is the time. Okay. So this is the mechanism, very simple, to make it forget.
Okay, so assemble cookie system, we don't need to go through the code,
okay? Basically, you can implement everything by yourself. In assignment one, although we don't say that you need to do the login,
but assignment one do one very horrible requirement, okay? How many of you have read through the specification? No one, huh? Yeah, no JavaScript, of course, okay. So there is a requirement called resume, okay? So, yeah, what is that resume? Resume. Okay, it's called session management, okay? What I'm asking you to implement is something like this. This is the steps.
You upload a photo, you edit it. Let's say you create some annotation. Don't use my photo. Every year, people demonstrate their stuff, put it in a Facebook photo. Okay. Yeah. Try to grayscale very horrible. Okay. Yeah. Then do something and terminate the browser. Okay. What we are asking you to do is when your browser responds to this termination. Okay. You don't forget that cookies. Okay. You save it in the browser. Once you reload your page, let's say you're using a Chrome capability to save all the tabs and relaunch tabs, then there is a resume button to let you to go back to this step. Okay. So basically, I want you to remember who you are, but without the login mechanism. Okay.
So the mechanism is very easy to implement. Just have a section storage that you put on the server side, okay?
Some people will love to use other database, go ahead, okay? Maybe you want to use Redis, you want to use, Mongo, MySQL, SQLite, you just go ahead to use whatever database you want, as long as you can install it in your Docker. Okay, and tell our tutor that you are using customized Docker. Okay, but our tutor just assume everyone uses MySQL. Okay, so you have to do it by yourself if you want to do it, and ask our TA to pull your make sure you make it public, of course. Pull your image to the demonstration environment. All right. So this is session storage, so you log in, okay?
If you want to play with my system, okay, remember the keyword, okay?
The login name is TY Wong, the password is so sad, okay? Every time it's like that, okay? So then you just fire the request and ask the login program to verify your identity. After it's passed, okay? No matter you are doing a hash page, if you are using MySQL, there is already automatic way to do the checksum, or let's say SHA 256, something like that. Then you save the SHA 256 hash value to your session storage, okay?
So that when the browser come back with the same section, you know who this guy is and what is their previous steps they have done in our system, okay? So. You can read it by yourself because I want to go a little bit faster today so that tomorrow we can start a new topic. Okay? So the logout just destroy all the sections. Okay, so what is the best practice in implementing a persistent HTTP cookies?
Okay, I looked this up reading some of the documents, and we find that Ripple, how many of you have used Ripple? Never heard of that. Or I pronounced wrongly.
Drupal, P-A-L, right? No one know what I'm talking about? Drip, Yeah, it's a triple. How do you pronounce that? Triple. No, it shouldn't be triple. Okay. Yeah, this is the open source CMS, okay? I find after I read some of the documents, okay,
there is some best practice in maintaining persistent cookies. So what is the meaning of persistent cookies? Okay, so I don't expect that you will do the following, okay, although I know many people do it.
Let's say you create a section in your assignment one.
Now, what you just said, find that you expire that section. Yeah, until 2036. Is it a mechanism, okay? Or you choose to expire random time, okay? Yeah, this is not the way, okay? Because why? I've told you about a story, okay? I teach the part-time MSc course, okay? I teach people how to dump all the cookies. Let's say I pick up your laptop, okay? I detach your hard disk, then I can discover all your cookie section. We create everything in my browser that I can pretend to be you without needing your password, okay? So this is not the way. You should not create a section storage inside the database and say that, yeah, let's expire it for 100 years, okay? After 100 years expired, no, okay? Because people can make use of it when it's being stolen, okay?
So what is the best practice in maintaining this?
Okay, so we have several goals. Okay, so what are the goals? First, the cookies can easily be stolen. This is an assumption. Okay, we assume that everybody can steal your cookies. And persistence cookies is equivalent to your credential. Because we present the cookies, then you don't need to do the login, just like you're using Gmail, right? How long you didn't log in for your Gmail account, right? I didn't log in for a Gmail account for I don't know how many months already, okay? Because the credential already saved as the form of cookies inside your browser. And now let's take a look, okay? Those guys that attend my lecture, okay, they know how to do it, okay?
So to do it is very, what happened to me? To do it, okay? To do it is very simple, okay?
What we aim is just one thing. To minimize the damage, I assume that my cookie is always available for the thieves, okay? I want to minimize my damage, okay? So damage is I can make it render the session cookies or render some of the cookies useless very frequently. That is my goal, okay? So what can you think of, okay? How about we frequently update our cookies, okay? So there is at least, you have two cookies, so that's why you have seen in a Gmail, in a Facebook, they have different duration of cookies expiry time. Some is long, some is short, okay? Let's consider the long one to be the ID, that's you, okay? To represent you. Of course, we don't dump out let's say it's Gmail system. We won't dump the user ID inside the Gmail. Maybe we modify it a bit. Let's say it's a hash value, and then it's a section. Okay, and assume that whenever there is a people, there's a thief and steal this pair, then your credential is lost. Let's imagine it's like this. Okay,
now this cookies usually is generated once you log in successfully. Okay. Then inside the
what happened outside? Wow, the other side get off the class so early.
Okay. Yeah, they already finished. So they are not finished. Okay.
Their lecture finished. So this is the database that you can imagine. Okay, I just copied some of the documents in the internet, okay? So they just translate this username and ID cookies. Maybe you can conjunct it using something like this. Okay, so what is that? Doing MD5. We never directly doing MD5 with your credential, okay? Remember, your username as well as your password are all important. They are as important as the other one, okay? people always think that password is very important. The ID is also important, right? Remember the case that you still remember your password but you forget your ID. Yeah, always say this, okay?
So, we have to protect it using this, and the section may be just a random number, okay?
Of course, the RAM here, it depends, okay? I prefer to generate a random string, okay? Maybe you prefer to generate a random number. It's not up to you, okay? Then, what's next? Next, we go through this flow chart. Once you finish your login, let's say you close your browser, okay, or you go elsewhere. Now, imagine that you come back to the website, come back to the Gmail, Facebook. Then what should you do? You just QA the ID, okay? And if I find that, yeah, that's you, okay? Then your session ID exists in the database or not. If no, then ask you to log in, of course. Of course, then the time that, let's say, you need to re-log in to Facebook, re-log in your Gmail, usually they will already show you your ID, okay? And that's why. Okay, that's why, because they remember who you are, okay? And then, this is another path. You successfully log in. The next step, the system will do the following. It is very special. We'll clear your old section, regenerate one. Okay? So the purpose is very clear. I know that my section always exposed in a Wi-Fi environment or in the network, okay, or someone will steal my laptop, okay? So what should you do? You just keep on regenerate a new one very frequently. Maybe this trigger is not at the login time, but every time you query something from the database, from the web service, then you regenerate one, clear the old one, regenerate a new one, okay? So I remember some of the system is already doing something like this. You can see their cookies updated very frequently, okay? Then let's say your cookies really being stolen, okay? So what should you do? Okay, let's say your credential pair is this guy, your stolen pair is this guy. I use the color to represent it. Okay, so the white color is the pair that you're being stolen. Let's say at a particular moment of time, you don't know you're being taken away, that the pair, okay? And that pair is still inside your browser. You do something, let's say you re-log in or you do some modification to your system, let's say you check your email. Then the section is being updated and the thief version no longer useful. Okay? So this is the way to implement it. Okay? And the best part of it, what is the best part of it? Okay? The best part of it is here, we use the ID cookies with a random number so that you can become different members, or I'm just saying different members, different identity when you use at a different browser or different machines, okay? So you can have different ID and a session pair together. When you are coming to the different machines, multiple login environment, okay? So I bet my COHK don't know about this, okay? Yeah, just append a random number, then yeah, I know who you are.
Of course, that random number has to remember inside the database, okay? Or I don't know who you are eventually. Okay. So the best practice is there.
The last one. Good, that's over time. Very good, I have enough time. So tracking cookies, okay? So the tracking cookies is the first half of the story. When I talk about JavaScript, then I will tell you the secret in how to implement Google Analytics, okay?
Do you know what is Google Analytics? Did I show you? If you have taken my OS course, I already shown you, okay? If you didn't, okay, this guy. Okay, I should have shown you. Let's take a look at our course homepage. Course homepage here. What? It should be the old cookies. This is the new, okay. Oh my God, no one is visiting. Ay, poor. Can you see this? We have a poor visiting. No one visit. Where's the day? Oh, during the Lunar New Year. Okay, no one comes. Zero, zero, zero. How come? Then two people come to see whether we have the assignment one. No, no, no. Okay, and well, why? Why zero? Because on that day we have a good discussion. Okay, so no one need to look up the web. Okay, okay. Then I don't know why Wednesday people come. Okay, yeah, so be it. Okay, then yesterday. Yo, why there's only one? I didn't change the URL. Oh, okay. Yeah, next I update it. Next time I update it, okay? Or maybe let you see some colorful things, okay? The ENGG 1010, okay? It's better. Yeah, 100 something. Yeah, just a sinusoidal thing, okay? Because we only have one day lecture. Okay, so at Wednesday people comes, and other than Wednesday no one comes. Okay, so we will implement half of it today. Okay, what is the half of it? First of all, how to trace people. First of all, you will imagine that I want to trace people. That means that every pages they visit better to become a CGI program, right? Then when you touch my program, let's say index.html now become index.cgi. Then whenever you load my script, I can record everything from your browser. Your browser tell me that your IP, okay, your browser type, whether you're using Mac machine, Windows, or Linux, we all know about this. But it is not the case, right? You don't change your web system to every page into a CGI program just for tracing purpose. It's nonsense. Okay, no one will write any web page anymore. Okay, so when I want to inject this kind of thing, we are not doing so. We are doing something really carefully done. Okay, so imagine this is the case. Okay, there is a evil owner. Okay, evil owner of this page want to do some evil stuff, want to trace people. Okay, and we want to invoke the CGI program as I explained previously. I want to see the following. The user agent environment, okay? So what is the user agent environment? Still remember that? The user agent environment will give you the following. Will give you this. Which browser you're using? Will give you this. What are the Windows sucks, okay? Yeah, you know, year one course, okay? Forgive them, okay? Forgive them. They are just year one student, okay? If it is going to be 350, I will kill them, okay? For your course, don't use Windows, huh? Yeah, I give you some penalty later, okay? Remote address, okay? To look up your IP address, but Google Analytics don't allow us to do it because it's just an infringement to your privacy, okay? But in my implementation, I will remember, of course I already deleted this, okay, become XXX, okay. I know who you are, who just visit my site, okay, and who is this guy? This guy is very hardworking. Yeah, it's 9-4 means that you're in COHK network, okay. Wow, this guy is hardworking, huh? From this page, go to lecture, then go to assignment, get to tutorial, basically browse through everything, okay? Yeah, this guy, I don't know what this guy is doing. Then it switched, okay? This guy switched from one place to another. Look at the IP. From 94 something. 94 something should be ELG wave, okay? Then go to 240. That guy is living in dormitory.
This should be an IP that when you're using VPN, okay?
Yeah, and this is the IP that guy using internally. This is a proxy IP. This is the internal IP. Okay, wow, sorry. We have so many visitors, 600 and something unique visitor. Okay, so how I do the following, how I know there are unique visitor, how do I know there are visitor coming back, okay? Let's take a look at the previous guy. Previous guy is coming back. from, you know, Sissy. This is the 3rd of February, and that guy come back on 4th, and still look at this page, and come back at 10th.
Okay.
And look at phase 1 because that guy need to prepare for the meeting. Then, Valentine's Day, that guy still look at the page. Okay, sorry about that. Okay, yeah. Or maybe that's me, okay? I don't know who, okay? Because I cannot. Oh, what is the IP? The IP is so strange. Or maybe this is IPv6 IP, so I record it in the bad way. Okay.
Wow,
Navigator using one dot? Oh, I don't know. Oh, that guy has a home, okay, in Hong Kong, using Navigator. Okay, so this guy is stranger, using Navigator, has dormitory. Okay, who? who is using Navigator and has a dormitory? Okay, then yeah, I can do a tracing. Now, how can I do it? First of all, you cannot see that I have any CGI program as the extension of destination. I just use PHP, okay, believe me, okay? Although I'm using PHP, I'm not using PHP to trace you guys, okay? I trace you guys using this way. What is that? Let's imagine that I embed a CUHK logo in a page, okay? And that logo is actually not a logo, okay? So what is that? It's this. In our course homepage, already have this guy. Here. I will remove it tonight, okay? Don't worry. Spec. Elements. Let me close the console. How can I close the console? Okay. Don't worry, yeah? This guy. Okay? This guy. And I said that, I tell the web page, tell the browser that this guy is IMG. It's an image. Is it an image? Yes, it's an image. 1 pixel times 1 pixel transparent GIF. Okay? I use a Photoshop generator 1 times 1 transparent GIF, okay? And save it in a server. And my tracking.cgi program is actually doing some tracking mechanism first and then read that GIF and return to you. So that the browser won't complain about that, hey, you said there's IMG but I cannot display that. Okay, eventually I give you the content. Okay, now that brings you to the next question. What is the next question that I want to ask? Is, okay, be very careful. Did I start recording?
Oh.
Yes, don't worry. Don't be scared, okay? You are the one who be scared, not me.
Don't scare yourself.
Okay? So let's say, let's pick Adobe, okay? I just received Adobe, okay? So can you explain why Gmail or every email client would block images in the first place? Now it makes sense. Because everyone knows this technique. Okay? When you have images coming in, actually they may be tracing program. They may be tracing program. And I know it for more than 10 years of 15, okay? Because once these features come into email client, they already tell us that, yeah, if you don't want to be traced, turn this on, we will block every images. But now it's become a default, okay? Every browser will only, based on your preference, you say that, yeah, you believe this guy is an innocent guy, then you always show their images. I don't trust them. Let's take a look, huh? I don't know what will happen, but usually it's only a normal and unharmed stuff, okay? So let's go to the resource. Go to the network, okay? We focus as IMG, okay? And I reload the browser. Okay, the browser is reloading. Okay, so all the photos now is not coming from the Adobe newsletter. It's just coming from Gmail, okay? So then I go to the bottom, I see the spinner, okay? Can you see this? It's just GIF, okay? Then I click this display image, then the new stuff will be coming from Adobe Newsletter. Go. Okay, it's keep loading. Some images here, and that's all. That's all. No further images. Now let's take a look. So after this spinner, all the images are coming from the time that I press the button. Can you see so many images? I just seen two, right?
The iOS download and Android download, but there's more.
What are they? Some GIF, okay, it's from Gmail. Yeah? Do you believe that this strange link point to something useful? Yeah, let's take a look. Some GIF, transparent. Okay? Now this is more horrible. To me, this is a script.
Yeah, it looks like a script, right? How can I know this looks like
a script? The equal sign. Is there any question mark? No question mark. Maybe this is not a script. Ah, this looks like a script. Google user content proxy, blah 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 blah. And what is dimension? 1x1. GIF. Ah, okay. So this is one of the tracing technique. Okay. And if you load, this is a kind of a feel. Okay. I load some of the email is horrible. Like loading email from which one? Ah, the one in the spam box. Usually the one from the spam box is really awesome. Okay. So yeah, this kind of thing should be very awesome. But no images. I don't know what this is. No image. Yeah, you just ignore the worst, okay? Ignore the worst. We are doing academic research now, okay? The worst is a guy to ask you to click, okay?
I told you to not to search
XXX,
okay?
Okay. This time I don't search XXX, just my spam box. What else? Oh, maybe this one. Ah, this time has images. Okay. So first of all, should be no girls' photos here, right? Yeah, this seems to me that they are place name, okay? Okay, so again, we load the browser. Eh? No, sorry. We load the wrong guy. Okay. Inspect. Network, IMG. Network, IMG. Oh, it's asked me to reload. Okay, I reload. Okay. So a bunch of things are coming up. Okay. So let's remember this BOD is the last guy. Okay. Yeah, I know what you're thinking. Okay. So BOD is the last guy. All right. Now load. Yeah, so many things pop up. Seems to be innocent, okay? Innocent. All are innocent images, okay? Then come here to take after this BOD. Yeah, look at some GIF. Yeah. They are malicious. The JPEG is okay. Usually the GIF. See, again, 25, oh, this is a magnifying glass.
Google
1x1, again. Yeah, Google has a tracing service from Google App Engine. Google App Engine has tracing service. Maybe this app is hosting in a Google Web Service. Okay? So, yeah, that this, to you, what is this? You know CGI now. Question mark, something, okay. You believe that it is a GIF or it is a photo? I don't believe it. Okay? It's not having anything as well. Okay? Preview? Nothing. Okay? Let's take a look at the header. The length. Now this guy is even more horrible. Okay.
I don't know what to say, okay? previously I showed you one times one GM is still legitimate, okay? Now this guy is zero length, okay? Purely is a tracing thing, okay?
So the tracing thing can be as horrible as the previous thing, but if you want to implement it, it's very simple. Just do something, you save all the environment, okay?
Then do some good stuff, okay? Don't say that content name is zero and then edit, okay? I will load back the CUHK icon for you, okay? Wow, and print this out to send out, okay? So and so forth.
Then you can pretend to be some innocent script, okay? Now, this is the first half of the story. The first half of the story is I steal all your environment, but how did I know you are the return user? Oh, time's up, so, one more thing, okay? So the return user is very simple.
I just check whether you have tracking cookies. If you don't have tracking cookies that I previously inject there, I will save a tracking ID generate specially for your browser, okay? And the expiry time is 10 years later. Okay, 10 years later it will expire. Then next time you come back, I know who you are, and record the time that whether you're old guy, you're returning user or not. Okay? So this is a technique. Okay? And the way is to inject a little image. Okay? For the Google Analytics, how Google Analytics is doing, they are not using a small GIF. Okay? They are asking you to inject a JavaScript code. You are the owner, right? You inject JavaScript code, and JavaScript code will do something, okay? And of course, the one of the things is to inject cookies so that we know that who you are, whether you're a return user or not, okay?
Now, before we go to the next chapter, I have some discussion point here. We will start this discussion point tomorrow, okay?
And there are some very critical questions. Whether this is a dangerous app, right? What is the sensitive information that you lost to the one who traced you? Okay? Or let's say the one who traced you is Google. Okay? Google using the AdWords all around the world, right? Even in some of their underground sites, they use AdWords. Okay? So the AdWords generate an ad, and the ad can also inject cookies to your browser. Now, can Google know who you are, basically? Let's say you don't have any Gmail account, okay? Then can Google map who you are, okay? Or this time it's not Google. Think about it. You are going to visit a site, okay? Let's say the AWS, maybe Amazon product, okay? And later on, when you go back to Facebook, you see that advertisement in the Facebook feed. Have anybody have seen experienced it before? You go to some websites, then later on you go back to Facebook. Your Facebook feed has that product or that website advertisement immediately. I experience a lot. Okay, how many of you have this experience? Only you two. How about others? You guys don't use internet. Yeah, we actually have all kinds of this kind of problem. It seems that someone is tracing you and know who you are. But based on our previous demonstration, you think about it. What are the stuff that you have lost? Does it matter? Do you need any legislation action to protect yourself? Or you can go to NBA.com. You see a bar there. Yeah, lately I go to NBA.com to watch the All-Star, right? Then there is a bar pop up and ask you one question. And they says, we are using cookies. Do you want to go on? Right? Then they are changing something. And what are they? Yeah. Tomorrow I will explain everything here. Okay? So let's stop it.